Hello to everybody that is a follower and a subscriber of me. First of all, I'd like to say thank you to everybody that supports my YouTube channel. I'd also like to point out that you may notice in Far Cry 1, there's some games that have been cycling up. Does that mean I'm finished with them? No, that does not. I'm still going to be going back to them, but the one I'm really not sure about on my channel, and you guys might expect it, is Far Cry 1. Far Cry 1 was very hectic for me. I tried to record a video on the carrier level, and everything went well except for the part when you get to that deck and there's people on top of the carrier, there's people in front of you, there's a person operating a turret, and there's also another person above him also, and I cannot pass that. So I went up online because I wanted to see if I was curious if I was the only one or not that was experiencing that difficulty. And I ran upon a person on, I believe Quora, Reddit, that said that, yep, they are playing the easy difficulty like I am in the video, and they said it's the most hectic Far Cry game they've ever played. At the time, they really haven't played 2. I've noticed that a lot more people have been watching me play 2, but I don't know if I'm going to, I think I'm going to continue doing more gameplays on it, but I don't know if at a certain point I'm going to be stopping right there for a little bit just to take my mind off of it or not. I'm also unaware of if I'm going to be returning back to Far Cry 1 because it gets on my nerves, and I've read other people's opinions that gets on their nerves too. It's also, I believe, the least popular of the series. Correct me if I'm wrong, but Far Cry 2, what's so annoying about it is when you clear out an outpost, guards will still respawn there. I've heard a lot of people complaining about that. It's like, why even bother clearing them out? Just go finish the game if guards are just going to continue to respawn there over and over and over again. It's a constant chore, especially when you try to sleep there at an outpost that you've already cleared out. If you try and sleep there, there'll be a guard in your way to sleep when you go to sleep and save your game. It is very, very annoying. But I have, as of today, I did put up a Far Cry Primal video, and I actually enjoy it a lot more than I thought I would. 3 through 6 is a whole lot better than 1 and 2, in my opinion. I know a lot of people have mixed opinions about 2, but so feel free to share your opinions about the Far Cries in the comments below. I'm trying to make some more room because I actually rebought 4 because of how much I like 4. I have it for my PS4, but I had a save file on there, so and it's a game that I like so much that I decided that I wanted to do a gameplay commentary for the whole thing. And as you can see on your screen right here, I'm actually deleting some space to make up for it. But 3 through all the way to 6, including Primal and New Dawn, I think I'm very well enjoying, because you don't have, and that's another thing that aggravated me about 2 was there's no fast travel. You have to constantly drive and drive and drive to make your way around the map. There's a GPS in your truck when you drive around the map, and there's also a map that you actually have to hold, and it can it can really throw you off, especially if you're trying to look for another outpost to clear out. It just shows absolutely nothing but north, east, south, west, and all that stuff. And there's like dots on the map to where your next story objective is. There's a select button to answer the phone, which that's a good feature. I like that you can actually see the player answering the phone. And the reason I actually picked Mardi is because I believe by what most people are saying, Mardi is supposed to be the main character for Far Cry 2. So that's why I picked him, even though you can pick from a different variety of characters. And yes, I also am aware of that the villain in Far Cry 2 is the Jackal, aka Ubisoft has also confirmed that it's actually Jack Carver, the protagonist from the very first game. And that's it really makes you wonder what made him decide from becoming a hero from the first game to all of a sudden want to sell drugs to Africa. It's a weird thing to think about. But anyway, I thought that this would be a great time for me to just express my honest opinion about those Far Cry games and to let everybody know. It's not a permanent thought, at least not right yet, but I'm seriously thinking about at some point, especially Far Cry 1, quitting. For the time being, to take my mind off of it. I may still do Far Cry 2, like I said, but that's what I'm aiming for right now. So I hope y'all enjoyed this little talk, and I'll continue getting everything set up and make some more awesome videos for you guys. Another thing I'd like to say is thank you very much for your support for Monster Energy Supercross. Yes, I have 1-5, and yes, I am aware that 6 is coming out on March the 9th, and about the pre-order bonuses, yes, but I don't know if the pre-order bonus and the park are worth $60, so I might hold off on that, especially since I'm in the middle of the very first one for you guys. So thanks a lot for that appreciation, and also thank you to the PSN followers that I have too. I really appreciate that. Well, I hope you all have a fantastic day, and I'll see you all in the next video. Thank you. Bye.